is yawning. Bagels on the counter. I think I'll make her a cup of tea. She's mumbling and she's giggling. I wonder what she's thinking. I wake her in an hour and then I'll ask her what it means.
Good evening. Welcome to Tranny Star Galactica. I am Sama, and this week's question is by Jenny. Jenny asks us to tell us about someone in the transgender community who's been a positive influence for you. So I'm going to revisit something hard. I want to tell you about Krista. Krista Easter. I could call her any time of day or night, and she was great to talk with. And it helped that she was sort of who I bugged when I couldn't sleep. Like right now, it's 4:30 in the morning, and I would have called her. And she'd have told me to take my ass to bed. But she was... She left too soon. She was a chef, and she was my go-to for recipes or any kind of techniques or inspiration. She would post all these pictures of her art, and I would just call her or text her and be like, how did you do that? How the F did you do that? And I always loved a chance to give her crap about her tattoos or her impulse buys. You know, it was just, she was someone great to know. I miss her a lot. She took her life just shy of a year ago, if you don't know. She went to the VA for help and didn't get it. And she went to her family for support and didn't get it. And she still participated in Tranny Star Galactica, and she kept her own channel going because she offered that to people. She didn't want to not be the support that she didn't get. You know, so many decisions that she made put her in a bad place, but being trans wasn't one of them. That was an affirmative decision to become her true self. And I'm very proud of her, and I'm glad she got that far in life. It's fair to say that not all trans people make it that far. Krista was a positive influence because I trusted her with intensely personal things. And for some things, she was the first to drag it out of me. For some of those conversations, they're going to die with her because... maybe what I needed to do was trust somebody, and she was the person I trusted. And what I'll take with me are the memories of the time she was there. And when I die, my soul is going to catch up with her soul and kick its ass for leaving the party so soon when I'm just getting warmed up. But the influence, the legacy that she leaves with me is that I'm working with I'mAlive.org to build a national suicide hotline and online support chat for LGBT people who need help, who are in crisis, so that we all have somewhere to go with people who will understand and we don't slide off the map like Krista did. And it's probably the biggest undertaking I've ever done. And it's not my intended field. In fact, it was her field. She majored in psychology and then went on to be a chef. But yeah, so she majored in psychology. And I really think that she put everything she learned to use as best she could. So I'm building this program, and the annual convention or conference, the training conference this year for I'mAlive.org and the Kristen Brooks Hope Center is April 22nd, next weekend. And I'll be speaking at their plenary breakfast about what we go through as a community and what can be done about it, what can be done to help us all through. And I'm developing an intermediary program where our allies and people who are already certified volunteers will be able to listen and empathize and offer support and resources. And in the meantime, I'll be building a community of volunteers from our LGBT community so that we're there for each other just as much as we need our allies and our families and friends and worlds around us to be there and to be understanding of what we go through. So if anything is a positive influence, it's Krista on my life. For as much as I appreciate her influence, I wish that weren't the case. But to be fair, it is a reality of the trans community that a lot of us end up committing suicide. And suicide is preventable. And if I have anything to say about it, the rest of us are going to fare a whole lot damn better. Be well. I'll see you next week. Thanks, Jen. This is a great topic.
Up on that roof, they got a rock band playing, and we can talk about the meaning of